How's it, guys? Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. I'll appreciate the support. Today I'm going to explore this area and I'm going to look for some spots, and I'm going to show you how to identify a good spot for edible fish. Now, as you can see, it's overgrown with kelp. There's a lot of reefs, and right here is a lucky spot for a galjoen or a hottie to come in when the tide is pushing. So I'm going to walk around and maybe show you a thing or two. And the first thing that you should do is just come on low tide to see what it's like, where the rocks are, where the holes are, where there's kelp, and just plan where you're going to fish in an hour or two. Okay, so in about 3 hours time, this would be the spot where you can catch galjoen. There's a deeper hole there with water coming in, and then in about 2.5-3 hours there will be a lot of white working water running over these rocks, and this would make a nice feeding place for galjoen. So yeah, this is what I'm talking about. If you come early enough and you come on low tide, you can plan exactly where you're going to fish, where there's pinnacles and stuff you should avoid, where there's holes. And this is normally a good galjoen spot. Doesn't look like it now, but the tide is pushing, there's a lot of white working water coming over these rocks, and it makes a good feeding place for galjoen. And yeah, I just picked up a few sinkers, and it's just evidence to show you that we do fish here. And on a high tide, it's difficult to see where the rocks are, where the holes are. That's why we lose a lot of sinkers. Okay, first cast. Okay, so this is what we call peckers, and I'm not ungrateful, but I could really use a bigger fish now. Catching a lot of small fish lately, just looking for a 45 centimeter plus galjoen. Nou is maar die probleem op die spot. Als hy Ja man.
I think this is my 5th or 6th wattie. Still looking for that bigger one.
Put this one back. Ek kan voel dit is 'n klein vis, hy hardloop so met hom. Baie keer dan pik hy so, nê? Dan sal daai groot hotties op so insuig en uitspoeg.
Okay, so this one is a bit bigger, but still not what we're looking for. So yeah, let's put him back and look for that bigger one. Okay, so yeah, only a few pickers around, smaller fish. And yeah, there's been a few people that asked me, how do I identify a good fishing spot? And if you look at this spot here, it's fishing tide now, so the water is coming in. But as you can see, there's a swell at the back and it's just running through. It's not breaking, but it's still washing around. A lot of food giving oxygen to the water and giving movement to your bait. That's what the fish likes. Galjoen, hottentot, whatever it is. They like a little bit of working water. So this is not your identical Galjoen spot. Galjoen likes those white working water. This is for mostly for hotties, but you can pick up for junior. And as you can see, there's a lot of movement in that spot there around that kelp. And you can try all along the edges of the kelp, because normally the fish hides in the kelp and look for shelter. And this is what makes this a good spot. Okay, so the tide is pushing in now. As you can see, there's a lot of white working water over there, which will make a lekker spot for hotties and galjoen. But it's almost impossible to get your fish out. So we're just throwing here into the channels here around the kelp. We just saw a seal chasing the fish. So yeah, I think the fish went into the kelp now for shelter. But yeah, look at that nice working water there. That's what you're looking for, guys. But yeah, this will work as well. Because it's a bit deeper, it's good for the hotties. Just go back. Okay, so I don't think we'll be on this reef any longer, maybe one or two more throws, but this tide is going to push us off here. But probably the most important thing about fishing or hooking a fish is getting it out.
I saw a post on still fishing where they said there's no point in hooking a fish if you can't get it out. They were actually talking about braid, but I mean, if you hook a fish in this kelp, it is difficult to get it out. It is possible. So yeah, if the fish are biting, we have to make a plan and yeah, try and get it out. But yeah, let's make one more throw and then move to a different spot. Fast, Papa! Okay, so I've got a galley, it's size, it's just size. I don't really want to keep it, I'm just going to keep it in the pool and try and catch a bigger one. Yeah, maybe tag it. Come on! Fast, puppy! Officer!
Yeah,
oh, come on.
I'm here.
Hallie!
Huh?
Galjoen, puppy!
Galjoen!
Okay, so yeah, this was the spot I showed you earlier. And as the fishing tide's coming through, better and better, but yeah, some other tides. Hallie! We're just gonna release him.
So as we got to the new spot, I still had my 12-foot rig with a lighter tackle. And I hooked into some decent fish. I lost 3 fish in a row and I switched over to the 15-foot. And yeah, the fish just went off the bite. What normally happens is when you lose a fish or two, they will chase away the whole shoal, and I think that's what happened. So luckily on my last cast, I hooked into a galjoen, and it wasn't the size I hoped for. But this galjoen went around the kelp, went around the rock, so I had to go in. Fell down twice, but it's just all part of the fun.
Okay guys, I went for a little swim. I thought it was a bigger galley, but it's about 35-36 centimeters. I went for the heavier tackle, the 15-foot anaconda. And it's still fun to catch these size fish on this rod. I thought it was a bigger fish. But yeah, I'm gonna keep this one and maybe check if I can get another one. Okay, so I think I'm gonna call it a day. Got a hiding there on the diamond back and the lighter tackle, the little chinook has been open. I'm gonna switch over to the anaconda and heavier braids and hooks. The fish just went off the bite, so yeah, that's exactly how it works. But yeah, still enjoyed it, people had a lekker swim after my fish. And guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll look for that bigger fish next time.